What's going on, y'all, man? It's Official Dre Live, bruh. Now, what led me to today's video is simply, it came to my mind. But anyways, before I start the video, man, subscribe to the channel if you're new. Turn on notifications, man. We on the road to 400. So you feel me? You know, every little bit helps. You know, every little bit counts. Every little bit helps. You feel me? Working on a stream schedule, and second channel is in the works as well. I'm gonna be recording some videos for that. So probably I could stay ahead on that channel. You feel me? It may be one or two videos a week on that channel. Anyway, man. But links to that in the description, man. But let's get on with this video. So today, or tonight, wherever you're watching this, y'all, that it occurred to me that us people like looking at dumb shit. Now, what I mean by looking at dumb shit, I was on the internet, of course, and I was scrolling through YouTube videos, you feel me? And with the YouTube videos that I find that get the most views are obviously the satisfying YouTube videos, you know, people that find satisfaction, or videos that relax someone, right? For example, the one dude that cleans the dirty ass rug, for some reason that pulls people in. Somebody had the idea. Somebody had the thought to say, why not record me cleaning a filthy rug? Why not? And then people are going to like this. People are going to sub to this. It was all just a thought. This was a thought. And then people hopped on the train, I'm pretty sure. Or people that are doing their regular job just said, why not record this? Not edit it. Just say like and subscribe. We clean dirty rugs. Like, it doesn't bother me, but it does, you know, it makes me think about what we're really focused on. But then again, some people are so bored, it makes a lot more sense. And then there's also the videos of stupid shit. Stupid. I'm talking about what happens if you put a PS4 disc in a PS5. You know how much views that Joan has, bruh? You know how much views that Joan has from somebody just taking their PS4 disc and putting it in the PS5. You know how slow you gotta be mentally to click on that, bruh? You know, mentally I'm thinking about it. I'm like, what's so good about that? Like, bruh, literally, it's in the title what he's about to do. He's just about to put a PS4 disc in a PS5. Nothing will happen. You can't play PS4 games on the PS5. Oh, no, wait, you can't use a PS5 controller for PS4 games. There you go. But what it's mind-blowing, because I feel, and this is something that I know as well, that there are million. Go ahead and finish it for me, The Rock.
The Rock came out to surprise the millions. Of the Rock's fan.
Of people. There are millions and millions of people. Hundreds of millions. Hundreds of thousands of people. That want this to be their living. Be their saving grace. A lot of people during quarantine made a YouTube channel. A lot of people during quarantine figured out, why not post stuff? Why not? You know? Now me, I've had this channel since 2012, but I never thought to make a new channel. I just deleted everything on this one and uploaded on it. So I started taking YouTube serious about 6.5 months ago and understanding the YouTube algorithm and stuff like that. But what I'm trying to say is, the point I'm trying to make is, imagine that. Imagine you taking the time out of your life to record a video, and not just record a video, you go through the steps of editing a video, and you want this to be a good video. You don't want it to just be a quick edit and you post it. No, you want this video to appeal to. And then you also, take the time to make a great thumbnail. So you have a good YouTube video and you have a great thumbnail. And then also you have a great description and you also create tags to go with the description. You feel me? You do all this work, right? You do all of that, you feel me? To get like 40 views. Jeez. Now it's not all about views. I'm not trying to say it's all about views. I'm saying, you know that you took time out of your life to make this video, to make some type of good content, to post it on this, hoping people would come through to it. And it's going to pay off eventually. That's why I'm taking it serious. You have someone that simply takes a generated clip or wait, here we go. You got somebody that just records. That just records, no edits, no cutouts, no green screen effects. You feel me? Yeah, you have somebody that just records and posts it. Right? And this person could have just made their YouTube account. Or it could be a bot. You never know what's out there. But you will see that video pop up in your recommended. You will see that video pop up on the home screen with 1.3 million views. Now, I don't have a problem with it. But it makes me question the YouTube algorithm. Now, if you can see where I'm going with this, I myself don't understand the YouTube algorithm. I know it as, well, for the most part, what I know about the YouTube algorithm is if you have a specific type of content and you post that content regularly and you try to do something else, you may not get as many views, which I think makes sense. But then again, I'm thinking about it as if I'm posting reactions, gameplay, which I may also post gameplay tomorrow from the stream, of course. But if I'm posting reactions, gameplays, let's plays, and what, food reviews, I guess, on this channel, and this is something that people know my channel for, and I can push the video out to a certain demographic of people, would I lose views or would I gain more views? Or if I explore more options within YouTube, could I gain more views there? But then again, it also makes me think, is this why people make second channels? It's because they're defeated by the YouTube algorithm. I wish I had 1,000 people take a poll on this. You know, that's just something to think about. But in my mind, if I were just randomly one day to, on my second channel, for instance, say, what happens when you sharpen a pencil backwards, and that be the most viewed video on my channel, I will feel some type of way about that, because a lot of the videos that I upload take a lot of work. Well, not really a lot of work. It's enough, though. For what I'm working with, the editing software I'm using, the clips, the thumbnails I'm using, it's enough. Like, I think my thumbnails are good. I think my descriptions are great. They can be better. That's why I ask y'all to comment a way I can improve on my channel. But for right now, for what I have, I think I can do good. I think I can go far with what I have right now. I'm humble. But then again, sometimes I just don't know, man. I don't know what we see and the stupid shit that we watch. I've fallen victim to it once. I don't understand ASMR, though. I think it's weird. There's somebody whispering in my ear while they're eating food. I don't get it. I don't understand why people want to see a dirty ass carpet get fucking cleaned with whatever the fuck that thing is, you know. But that's just my opinion on it. And yes, I'm hating. Oh yeah, for sure. I'm hating. Oh, I want you to understand. Yes. Oh, I am hating. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But I respect the grind for whoever's trying to make it out here, man. Anyways, man, this is a little short video, 10-minute video. You feel me, bro? You know, it's a real question. Why do we watch dumb shit? Why do we find entertainment in looking at stupid shit, man? But anyways, man, subscribe to the channel if you're new. Turn on notifications, bro. We on the road to 1,000, bro. Even though we about to hit 400 in like a week or two, maybe a month. So with that being said, man, there's some videos on the screen. And until next time, man, I'm out. Peace.